So you want to invest in real estate? Well, I'm going to show you how. What's up, guys? Andrew Briscoe here, and today I'm going to be teaching you about investing in real estate as a beginner. Now, all you need to get started is some time and some money, which are both things we all have in bulk these days. Real estate's a great investment because it's really hard for people to just walk away from their business or home if they owe money on it, which means even if the economy goes down, it'll still be worth something, right? Just kidding, if you do it right, you'll be in the clear. I'm gonna show you how it works step by step, so by the end of this video, you'll be ready to buy your first investment property. The first thing to clear up is, what's the best method to buy your first investment property? There's a million different ways to invest in real estate. You can purchase real estate holdings on your phone through apps.
You can do buy and holds, rental property, fix and flips.
In just a sec, I'm gonna show you the method that I think is the best way to purchase your first investment property. But first, I wanna go over a few of these. The first one is called the BRRRR method, or BRRRR. BRRRR stands for buy, renovate, rent, refinance, and repeat. How this method works is you buy a property, rent it out to tenants for income, then you refinance the loan and use the cash as down payment for your next property. And then lastly, you repeat this process over and over, continuing to use the refinance money as the down payment to purchase your next property. Now, even within the BRRRR method, there's lots of different ways that people do this. One of my favorite ways to do it is combining it with something called house hacking. And again, even with house hacking, there's a few different ways people do it, but the main way people use the term house hacking is basically just purchasing a home and living in it as your primary residence, and then you rent out extra bedrooms to friends, college students, to make rental income. So the best way for you to purchase your first investment property is actually a combo of these two methods. Typically, to buy an investment property, you have to put 20% down. Now, that's for a home that you don't live in as your primary residence. But if you purchase a home to live in it, you can use a conventional or FHA loan and only have to put usually about 3 to 5% down. Now, this is great because not only are you saving the down payment money, but you actually, with an FHA loan, usually can get approved a little bit easier, and they're great for first-time home buyers. Now, with an FHA loan, they have a little bit stricter appraisal requirements. So if you're wanting to purchase a house as your first investment property that's a little bit more of a fixer-upper, you might have to go the conventional route. But either way, you're still saving a huge chunk of cash having to put 3 to 5% down compared to 20% down if you were to use an investment loan. Now, the other huge factor about doing this method is that you can actually purchase up to 4 units with an FHA or conventional loan as your primary residence. So this would allow you to buy a duplex, triplex, or fourplex under one loan as your primary residence, and you can live in one unit and rent the others out for income. So here's a breakdown of what this would look like, and I actually used a property here in my market so we can look at some real numbers, and you know I'm just not making these up like the gurus on TikTok.
Knowledge.
So here's the property. I went on Zillow and found a duplex for rent because there's actually not a ton of duplexes for sale in our market here. And I ran some numbers on it and found that it would probably be worth somewhere around about $200,000. So let's use this as our example. You buy a duplex for $200,000. With a conventional loan at 5% down, you would need $17,289 of cash to bring to close for your down payment and closing costs. Your monthly payment would be $1,354 with taxes, insurance, and PMI included. Now, you're only living in one unit and you can rent the other one out for income. Now, this property would rent out for about $1,000 a month in our market here, which would leave you with about $350 a month for you to make on your mortgage payment yourself. So while you're living in one unit and renting the other unit out for additional income, three things are happening. The first thing is that you're getting to live virtually for free. You're paying $350 a month to your mortgage because the renter is paying the rest of it for you. The second thing is that because now you own a piece of property, it's appreciating in value, usually at about 1 to 3% a year. And lastly, because your renter is paying your mortgage for you, or at least most of it, you are gaining equity in the property, which is also increasing your net worth. And on top of all of that, if you do decide to fix up the property, add some value to it, or even just wait a year or two until you have enough equity in it, you can do a cash out refinance and use that cash as down payment to go buy your next property. Now, I'm not gonna go in any detail on that for this video, but basically to recap, you can purchase an up to 4-unit property with a conventional or FHA loan, live in one of the units, rent out the others for additional income, and in the meantime, make tons and tons of money and become a millionaire by the time you're 20.
Knowledge.
As always, I hope this video was helpful to you. And if you have any other specific questions about investing in real estate or just buying or selling property, feel free to reach out and I would love to help you.